Hello friends, this video on heredity and evolution part 6 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So what were the new terms introduced? Autosomes, sex chromosomes, diploid and haploid cells. So we will talk about each of these terms in detail one by one. So let us start with autosomes. So let us look at autosomes in little detail. So these are the chromosomes other than the sex chromosomes. As I mentioned some time back also, that inside the human body, there are two types of chromosomes which are present inside the cell. One is a sex chromosome and the other one is autosomes. So these autosomes control different traits of the body. For example, eye color, eye shape, hair color, skin color, ear shape. So all other traits of the body except determining the sex of that individual is performed by the autosomes. Now these autosomes exist in pairs and each member of the pair have the same form, but they differ from other pairs in a diploid cell. That means when I talk of autosomes, all the autosomes, they will exist in pair. So these two autosomes of one pair will be exactly similar to each other. But if you compare this one member with another member of some other pair, they will be different. They control the somatic traits. Somatic. Somatic means something. The word somatic means something related to the body. So they control all the different traits of the body. So these are autosomes. In humans, 22 pairs of autosomes exist. As I said, in humans, there is a total of 46 chromosomes. Out of these 46 chromosomes, 44 are autosomes. Now, since they exist in pairs, that means two autosomes together. So we can say that 22 pairs of autosomes exist. The other type is the sex chromosomes. Now, these chromosomes determine the sex of an individual. That is, whether that individual is a male or a female. Now, how do these sex chromosomes function? That is actually very important. Now, in humans, one pair of sex chromosome exists. So, out of 46, 44 are autosomes. So, how many remained? Two. So, the remaining two are sex chromosomes. So, they also exist in pairs. So, we can say that one pair of sex chromosomes. Right? So now, how is the sex determined by these kind of chromosomes? As I said, during reproduction, the father as well as the mother, both will contribute equally. So what does the father contribute? The father contributes 22 autosomes and one sex chromosome. Similarly, the mother contributes 22 autosomes and one sex chromosomes. So now these sex chromosomes, which are contributed by the father and the mother, these together, the two sex chromosomes together decide whether the child will be a male or a female. Right? Now, how it decides whether it is a male, when, under when, which situation is the child a male and under which situation is the child a female. So that we will see in one of our next slides, that how that is exactly decided. So here in this picture, you can see the total 46 chromosomes in human males. So these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these numberings, they are all autosomes. And this last one, this XY, this is the sex chromosomes. So the sex chromosome in case of a male is denoted by XY. So this is how a male sex chromosome denoted in a human male. Whereas in case of a female, this is how it looks like. This will also have some 22 pairs of autosomes. And the last one, that is this one, is the sex chromosome. So in a female, it is denoted by XX. So in a male, the sex chromosome is denoted by XY. And in a female, it is denoted by XX. Right? So during reproduction, the mother will contribute one of these X. So the mother will always contribute one X. Right, because she has both X's. So one of these she'll contribute. So every time she'll contribute X. But the father has an option to contribute either X or Y. Now, depending on what the father contributes, the sex of the child will be determined. Now, if the father contributes X, then what will be this pair, this will become XX. And what is XX? It is a female. Now, if the father contributes Y, it will become XY. And what is XY? XY is a male. So, it will be male. So, basically, whether the child will be a boy child or a girl child is always determined by the father. Right? So, these are autosomes and sex chromosomes. Let us now talk about the diploid cells and the haploid cells. So, diploid cell, a cell with two complete sets of chromosomes. As I said, so in diploid cells, the chromosomes will always exist in pairs. So, here you can see. So, how is this pair formed? One set is given by the father, the other set is given by the mother. So, that is how this two sets actually are formed. Whereas, haploid cell is a cell with a single set of chromosomes. So, here you have just one set. So, examples of haploid cells would be the sperm cells and the egg cells, that is the gametes. Gametes would be the best example, because in case of gametes, each of these gametes contain only one set of chromosomes. They do not exist in pairs, right? But all other cells of the body, that is all the somatic cells, are examples of diploid cells. So, all other cells of the body are diploid cells. So, diploid cells will have two sets of chromosomes, and that is why chromosomes exist in pairs. So, one set from father, one set from mother. In haploid cells, they will have either the father set or the mother set. For example, the sperms contain the father set of chromosomes, the egg cell contains the mother set of chromosomes. Thank you. Please visit www.examfear.com to watch more videos, attempt free online test, get free study material, find tutors and mentors. Thank you once again.